Base 10. I'm sure you use it often. Start at 0, count 1 through 9. Add one more and now you have a single 10. Let's bring that over here. Keep going until you have 10 tens. Now you have a single 100. Base 10 is the decimal system. What about base 2? Instead of counting by tens, let's count by twos. Start at 0, now count 1. Add 1 more and you have a single 2. Count more and now you have 1 4. You can keep going, doubling each time. 8, 16, 32, and more. Base 2 is the binary system. A decimal clock is pretty typical, but how do you make a binary clock? One easy way is to use binary-coded decimal. Instead of turning hours, minutes, and seconds into big chunks of binary numbers, break up each decimal number into their own binary value. Now the 6 digits of a clock become 6 lines of binary. Each line needs to accommodate for decimal values of 0 through 9, so choose the smallest binary value you can to achieve this. 16 should do the trick. We don't want numbers greater than 9 in our lines though, so remember to keep track of when we have more than we need. We can carry this over to the next line to keep track of our tens place. Changing when we want our numbers to carry over can help us with the hours. We can make this even more interesting by making a 24-hour clock. We'll need a special carryover that knows when we have 23 hours stored. When we hit 24 hours, the first hour line will be reset instead of displaying 4. And now, we're ready to keep time.